contains. So we must believe, even though the soul that has infinite purpose, Satchit Ananda, is the nature of the soul, still we have to believe that whatever we have is infinitesimal before the repository of opulential status, the God. Before God, what we have is nothing. So we may be having something, but something before everything will become nothing. Something before everything and anything, that will become nothing. God is everything and we have something. So instead of, if we are just kept aloof, then we may say that we are something. But if we have a parallel view of something with everything, then it is better to accept that there is nothing. So that type of vinamrata, or status of humble obedience and subservience, is the primary requisite. And second thing, anybody who is having discrimination, anybody who is having discrimination and hatredness, they cannot be good healers. That's what I used to say to some people. You are fighting with your neighbor. You are fighting with your neighbor. And you want to establish a colony at Mars. And somebody talked about universal brotherhood. So most of the people, we cannot maintain brotherhood with our own brothers. And where to maintain brotherhood with our cousin brothers and distant brothers? So, hatredness, for example, to gain one unit of healing energy, it will take 1 month. And if you hate somebody by thought, and if you speak it out and do something as a product of hatredness, 100 units of energy will be lost in a fraction of a second. That sin which cannot be exhausted even in millenniums of years, that jandur iha krite kshanardhe. So hatredness and discrimination, those two things are the voracious consumers and diluters of your healing energy. Then there may be a question. As we are the bulk of biological instincts, naturally hatredness, unknowingly or knowingly, they will ooze out. We cannot immediately throw away our long-term companion. Over several cycles of birth and death, we have been accustomed. And immediately throwing out as a result of one day lecture, that may not be possible. For example, if somebody goes inside a bank and withdraws immediately 20,000 rupees, a person who is earning 20 rupees per month, he may be astonished how he is withdrawing. Already he has deposited and is withdrawing. Likewise, Gandhi, Sadi, Harishchandra, Nataka, and immediately he was transformed, means already there was a combat between goodness and evil inside his mind, either pre-natally or post-natally, over a succession of even several births, it would have been just pricking it inside. And as a small driving force, for example, if there is water hidden inside, buried inside the rocks, if you dig it, then immediately it will flow out. And in artesian spring, we can see it pressurized, the motion, upward motion of it. We can easily see that. So that clearly gives the idea that already that was there, and that hindrance, that curtain was removed by digging. Just as the resplendence or the luster of a diamond is brought out by polishing, by removing the upper surface which was a curtain, which was clouding that luster. It is not creating, but manifesting or removing the hurdle for manifestation. Likewise, those great people, they had already the luster, and immediately the polishing machine, that curtain was removed. Naturally, all souls, they do have the same instinct, but it takes time of centuries, decades, years, months, seconds, depending upon the person's spiritual status and also the influential status. Status of influence from an external authority and status of confluence by an internal authority, that gives you the rate of difference and rate of time taking for their cure or development. So likewise, these two qualities cannot be immediately thrown out. What is the thing for that? There are three things. One is repentance. First, we have to repent for our whatever we have done today, and we must not make the repentance. For example, if a latecomer should pay 1 rupee fees, that is a special way of giving a fine by which you are given an alert that you must not done the same thing. You must not consider exemptions and excuses and fine to be a regulatory exercise. Daily I'll pay 1 rupee and I'll come late. It is not for regulation. So repentance is no doubt a process, and you must not totally dedicate your life in a consistent methodology of doing mistakes, then repentance, doing mistakes, repentance. You must not make it as a process of your life. or something that was beyond your control, unknowingly done, you must take this repentance. So everybody, before treating the others, they must have self-cleansing by a process of repentance. Then after repentance, reformation is happening by one more step known as rectification. What is rectification? Rectification process is nothing but self-determination. So first repent, cry for your mistakes and be happy for that you have cried. So first you have to cry for your mistakes, and there are a lot of people who have been cried for mistakes, so you can laugh, you can be happy that you are sad after your mistakes. Then start the process of rectification by self-determination. For example, there are two types of sturdiness. Rock is sturdy because of its nature. Ice is sturdy because that is inside the temperature, not nature. If you remove it out of the, outside the fridge, then it will immediately become water. Then if it is heated, it becomes a vapor. Likewise, most of the people, we are sturdy like ice, not like rock. So more we are within the ambience of spiritual person's spiritual thought. For example, two things. One, your puja, your thought, your ahara, sangha, association. So many things are there. Whenever you are within the ambit of these things, you are like hard ice. Whenever you are taken out of the temperature of the refrigerator and kept under the normal temperature, then your sturdity is lost. So till you become a rock, be an ice. Always be in a company of elite and enlightening personalities. And either by a physical process or mental process. Whenever you are capable of being with them, enjoy the physical ambience. Whenever they are away from you, think of their teachings, then just imagine them in your mind and proceed with your routinal work. So self-cleansing is there. And the receptacle, he must also have some qualities. And the basic quality is belief. Belief in the healer and healing. And number two, that person must have also some sort of divinity inside him. So I always used to say, unless there is a configurative identity between two tools of communication, either a similar tool or same tool must be there. If it is not there, then there can't be any communication. Likewise, they must be having some sort of divinity to get divine vibrations. To get official concession, you must have some sort of connection with the office. And you must have done some work with the office. Likewise, some divine work must be there, which will give you the eligibility to get that. And there are 21 principles for an emitter or emanator of spiritual healing, and there are 10 commandments for receptacles, which we will just discuss in a very detailed session. So now we have understood the types of healing, forms of healing and methods of healing. I have already told that healing is not only for your diseases. There are two types of healing. One is augmentative and second is extirpative. Extirpative healing removes unwanted things from you. Repeat it. Extirpative healing removes unwanted things from you. And contributive or augmentative healing that implants wanted materials inside you. So now we are seeing only one face of one side of the kind of healing. Healing means disease, nothing like that. There is physiological healing. There is physiological healing. Four types of physical healing are there. One is healing of infections, they are different. Healing of genetical disorders or ancestrally transmitted diseases, that pathology is different. Incidental diseases due to age and other things, then accidental diseases, vipat sanjata. So all of these things are entirely different. Four major things are there, these diseases. Then the second thing is mental disease or psychological disorders. Very simple. Then they are on emotive imbalance. How to deal with your domestic, official and social status. How to deal with frictions. For example, misunderstanding between wife and husband. Misunderstanding between brothers and sisters. Misunderstanding between father and children. So these things are the major three, misunderstanding and frictions in family. And with cousin, brothers, nephew, niece, granddaughter and granddaughters, elders, and those things are different. The intimate area, these things are very essential. And there are healing methodologies.